And we're back.
I'm back with some more Myst. Alright, so we've successfully discovered two sets of pages, both red and blue. We've returned both of them to their books. And now that we can see cutscenes, we saw some interesting stuff going on there.
Yeah, with Akinar and Sirius going back and forth.
Yeah, they're both kind of like, you know, blaming the other one for like...
Akinar is saying that Sirius put him in the book and killed his dad, and Sirius is saying Akinar is batshit crazy.
Yeah.
Although, what I'm starting to think here is, like, you know, Akinar, we found his pages in, like, weird death rooms, like, severed heads, and all sorts of crazy stuff like that. But we found the Black Flag insignia in Sirius's room.
Yeah.
And he's also had lots of money, and, you know, his little, like, secret chamber that he has is more well hidden than Akinar's, and it's full of gold, and Akinar left him a note saying, like, hey, I know that you're taking gold and stuff, don't be a dick.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of led to believe that maybe Sirius has made this Black Flag cult and is traveling to all these different realms and just taking everything from them for himself and pillaging them as the Black Flag Raiders and stuff like that. And then he's just kind of building or maybe framing Akinar. Or maybe Akinar has gone crazy trying to figure out who this Black Flag cult is.
Well, we're going back to the Mechanical Age. That's what this one's called, right?
Yeah.
Mechanical Age. Excellent. And we're going to take a look around.
Any hidden passages in those hallways?
You know what?
Because, like, it's a hallway that you walk down, and it's kind of a...
I don't see anything. Weird shadow effects going on, but apart from that, it looks totally flat. I don't think there's any secret passages there.
Now, what's the note in, it would be at Sirius's secret room, so it's from Akinar. It's on the wine.
Oh, yes, that's the note about pillaging people's
stuff.
Yeah. Sirius, your greed sickens me. Your desire for wealth and plunder is never satisfied. I will instruct my subjects not to pay your new tax, and you know they'll listen to me. Regards, Akinar.
So it seems like Akinar is the leader of these subjects, and Sirius just wants all the money and stuff. But it's like, why is Akinar the leader? What did he do to become a leader?
Yeah.
I see a severed head and a chest. It's, you know they'll listen to me, because I'll kill them otherwise.
Well, we know in, like, the monkey world, in Channelwood there, the humans were kind of, like, revered as gods.
That's true.
So they were, like, kind of worshipped there. So I guess if we're talking about that world, then they just kind of, by showing up there, got into that situation.
Gods, yeah.
But if we're talking about this world, it could be that... Because they saved the people here from the black ships, right?
Yeah.
By building the fortress. Now, I mean, that's another thing we have to think about. Because I gather Sirius would have been here when the black ships came. And, like, prior to the black ships coming. So, helping build the fortress with his father and his brother. So, I guess he couldn't really have been the black ships unless he became the black ships afterwards,
well,
maybe?
Well, did the black ships arrive while they were here?
Yeah, because they successfully defend it, and then they have, like, celebration dance or whatever afterwards. So.
Were the Suns present for that? Or did he send them back already to Channel World or something?
Oh, that's a good point. That's a good point. He might have... You know what? I think he did send the Suns away because he didn't want them to be here or whatever. I know they helped build the fortress, but maybe they weren't here at the time, so I guess...
Or did Sirius know the plans of the fortress, know the weak spots to attack, and wasn't planning on his father being there to stop it himself?
I don't know. Because we know that the black ships were fended off, right?
So yeah. But they said until the enemy is defeated, the sky will remain cloudy.
Right.
What's the sky look like now?
I was just thinking the same thing. Let's go have a look outside. It looks all right.
No, it doesn't look dark and gloomy at all.
I mean, then again, we figure that Sirius hasn't, like, neither of these guys have been around, like, for a while, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this guy looks okay. Yeah. Maybe a little less than blue, but nice and bright.
Now, another interesting thing, too, is Aknar, right, has learned the language of the monkey people, as we saw when he left little notes in the monkey language.
Right.
Which is what I'm assuming that gibberish was. And Channelwood. With Sirius, I don't think he learned the language. And it even says in the Channelwood book that my son is picking up the language nicely. Yeah, there's the head, man, like... with all the poison in the heads.
Alright, do we want to try using the clues here, or...?
Well, I don't really know where to click.
Because, like...
Look at the map. We'll look at the map.
Look at the map?
Yeah.
Oh. Right, let me open this elevator up first. Because having access to this elevator is probably a good idea.
Yep.
Two more rotations. Should do it. And there we go.
There we go. Okay.
Fortress Head contains many mysteries in the campaign. That's nice. Let's take a look at that. Okay, so, South Island. Sunken Stairs to Myst Book. So, yeah, down those stairs at the start, that's where the Myst Book is.
Yeah. East Island
podium with code symbols.
North Island podium with code symbols.
Rotating fortress. Why does it look like it's pointing at that right now? I don't know. Probably irrelevant. This map is probably the same no matter what. So, we need to rotate the fortress. Move in all directions, think in circles, discover everything. Hints. Okay. Do we wanna screw around with more hints, or like...
I'd like to figure it out on our own, but there's a lot of stuff here where it's just like, okay.
Well, I mean, it said move in circles, so... can't walk over there, though. All I can do is turn around.
You go upstairs.
Well, I'm inside of a circle, and I'm now moving.
So moving in circles.
Totally moving in circles at the moment. It's moving in cylinders, I guess, because we're talking three dimensions here.
Yeah.
Again, I can't walk over there or anything. I can look at this ceiling, though, like...
hit the up arrow.
Can't click it. Like, I definitely feel like there's... I mean, that looks like two levers up there to, like, operate fortress rotation or something.
Yeah.
The question is, how do we get there?
You gotta, like... get the elevator to the medium button. Because that looks like it's on top of the elevator. And can you quickly run out? Got it! Nailed it!
There had to be a reason for that medium setting, right?
Yeah, there we go.
We don't need hints, do
we? We got it. We're going.
Alright.
Yeah, what's the red button
so...
do? It's gonna lift the elevator back up. Okay. It's important. This is important information to know.
Okay. We've got this. We've totally got this. We don't need no stinking hints.
You know why they teach us how to operate it? Why? Did you ever see a map with the current fortress rotation?
No.
How many seconds did you have to hold it down for?
Oh, boy.
Yep. It's gonna be one of those.
Okay, so
bridge
crank
is
that
in.
Sucker up.
I guess we'll find out where we went.
Are we good? I don't know.
Turn around and see what... Yeah, it's the same before. Well, I guess... We go downstairs and figure it out.
There it is. Maybe it worked. Walk outside, the bridge is just pointing in the middle of the water. Okay.
Go back in. Eventually we'll get it. We're on the right path.
Yeah, well, we know how to rotate the forges now, so I think we're good. We can basically solve this age. Pretty much all we needed.
Yep. It looks like it's a bridge over water.
Nope. We're connected.
Sweet.
Alright, let's take a look. What do we got here? Might want to write this down. Looks like we got a half sphere. A couple of ball spikes. I also need to write that, so.
Yep.
And that looks like everything that's here. I assume that's all that that thing is for anyway. So we're gonna go back inside.
Yeah, we just gotta get to the point where we unlock the Myst book. Let me just grab whatever page we want.
And then we're gonna...
Well, they said they need two more books, right?
They need two more pages.
Two more pages. So we can get both from this age.
Then we need to go to the spaceship age.
And then we can only take one. So we need to save by the time the spaceship age.
Really? We can only take one back?
Well, I'm assuming once we take it back and put it in the book, they'll be free.
Oh.
Because it'll be the last page.
Save game.
Yeah, save game.
We can create a second save file. Alternate endings!
Spoilers! They're all dead!
Spoiler. They're all dead. What is this?
You are in the book. They aren't.
An apocalypse movie? Alright, let's crank that up. That just rebound back, or like...
Yeah, it did. There you go. Now lock it. There.
We make silly noises. Dink. Dink.
Why did it make a different noise on the thing? Remember how it made the one noise at the south and the one noise at the east match the noises?
Yeah. It was teaching us how to operate.
No, it was! Yeah, we just didn't understand how to actually operate it, I guess. This is how you operate this thing, okay. Now can I try operating it? Oh, I'm good luck finding it.
Yeah. Well, that's why we can look up when we get up there, though, so that we
and
see
and we
it.
Saw it, we're like, those are, I'm pretty sure
that,
those
that
look
looks
like levers.
Yeah, that looks like the same levers that we used to operate the thing, and it's like, well, you know. Oh, oh, damn it, we went full circle.
So, let's figure out what the noise is that we want. We're on the south side.
Training sequence initiated.
Unless we got the north side before.
Yeah.
We never really checked that.
That's a good point. Map. Which one were we on? We were definitely on this one.
Winding pathway?
Yeah, the loopy path.
Okay.
Yeah, it had to be that one.
Okay, sweet.
Okay, so if we go like this, and then we go one steamboat, two steamboat, three steamboat, four steamboat. We're just gonna hold the thing for 4 seconds.
Okay, and then lock it? What's the noise? Angry alarm clock is the noise we need.
Well, I think that lags out, so it'll probably like do like a beep beep beep.
Still, angry alarm clock is the noise we need. Wait for it to load before we can leave.
It's so painful when I click on this when I don't need to. That's okay. Everything's
okay. I think we're starting to get the hang of it.
Top floor, please.
Thank you. Middle floor, please.
Goodbye. Tower rotation, yes, please.
So part of me was thinking, hey, you know, why did he make this crazy business? By he, I mean the guy who's either written the books or had the library, the main guy.
Do we know his name?
It was signed on the first piece of paper we saw, addressed to Catherine, but I can't remember.
Right. Atrus.
Atrus. So, like, why did Atrus go through the process of making so ridiculous things? Four steamboats.
One steamboat, two steamboat, three steamboat, four steamboat.
Oh.
Maybe the sounds don't mean anything. Okay. I don't know. Let's go check there.
But I was thinking, like, why did he make such crazy stuff all the time?
Because he's mad.
Well, if one of his sons is batshit crazy and murders people, and the other son is a greedy bastard who wants pirates in his spare time, I would be building shit backwards crazy as well. Just, you know, keep it secret, keep it safe. Yeah, so
we went full circle.
Okay, so two steamboats.
Okay.
Makes sense. If four is a full circle, then half of it would be 180 degrees.
That training thing... Oh no, I don't need to do this. I already did this. So that was literally just to open the hole there.
Yeah.
That's all that that was for. And we just don't do it. Well, that's fair enough. I can accept that. Put the tower rotation controls on top of the elevator.
So what if the elevator breaks down? How do you get out? Where's the emergency switch?
Really well designed. Alright, disengage bridge. One steamboat, two steamboat.
It's a different sound.
Let's lock it down.
We might have different sounds. They lag out.
I don't think that training thing means anything. The times don't match.
I think it was just to teach you whether or not how to disengage the brake or whatever. You've been to this one, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, go double check.
We just got to the first one. Yeah. I'm pretty sure this is the one we were at.
Yeah.
See.
Well, if two steamboats got us to this one, just two steamboats again.
It's gonna take us full circle. It's like, you know you can't go to that one. This is gonna screw with us. Dankelberg.
Basically. How does this place going?
Fairies! Everything makes sense now.
This is a fantastic show.
Alright, so we just need to rotate a little bit.
Just two steamboat it.
Alright, first things first, disconnect the bridge. We see the gears rotate a little bit here?
Yeah.
And then we'll just... I don't want to go too far, right?
That should be it.
No, it's not.
Do it. Lock it.
Yeah, because it keeps rebounding, right? So I just want to, like...
Yeah, you definitely gone way too far. See? That's the noise the first thing made.
Okay.
And then immediately lock it.
That's the second.
Now lock it.
The same one.
There you go.
Alarm clock. So the noise is too much. Alright. So there is, like, an actual reason for that training thing to
exist.
Okay, well, that's good, because I thought it was redundant. You know, when the times didn't match up and stuff, like. You know?
No, it's going for the audio cue. Because remember what it says on the back of the box of Myst, is open up all your senses.
That's right.
Audio cue, visual cue.
Apparently not my sense of temporal reality.
Yeah.
That one won't help you here.
Yeah. Well, clearly not. Everything's like semi-frozen in time.
Alright, we got like...
moon and square spikes.
Homer Simpson donut. Spikes for that. Rectangle. Spike, rectangle, spike. One of those is an upside down spike.
Yep, I got it.
Okay. Great. Nothing else on this island, that's fine. Alright, let's go grab a page to take back with us. Whose page do we want to take? We'll take Sirius, because we just happen to be in the dream. The page is in the secret passage.
It should be.
Why am I keep looking at this book? Okay, where was the page? There we go. It's lying in that chest there, on the floor there. Just found it lying there on the floor there.
You're gonna need to, like, you know,
rotate
the tower.
Yeah, I might want to do that.
At least you don't come back and don't try to the tower.
Right. We solved this, man. Didn't even need any hints.
That map is nice, though.
Oh, yeah, the map was helpful.
Out of the tower, out of the tower!
Oh, yeah, yeah, right, I need to jump out. Of course.
It gives you, like, a little countdown, too. It's like, are you sure you want to go to the useless floor?
Yeah, there had to be a reason for that. Unlock. Nope, we rebounded.
Let go.
Should be good now.
Yep.
Going down? Why, yes I am. First floor. This is not correct.
Oops. Went a bit too far.
Was that not the right sound? I guess not.
No, probably not. I'd be honest here, I'm all like,
Yeah, no,
I just gotta like check that one.
I was just like, nope, not an alarm clock. Nope, not an alarm clock. That's not an alarm clock, so it might be the right one. I don't know.
Actually, there was like a noise, like an air coming out. Which is this, right? Alarm clock, and then I guess the other one's like a metal clang?
It's like a boom. Right?
So how does this fortress protect them from pirates with a boat?
I don't actually know.
Because, like...
it spins around and, like, smacks the ships with, like, the giant arm. Like, get out of here!
They're like, what it is,
you cannot board us.
Is they land... and they're like, oh, well, we can't shoot you because you're a big metal fortress, or cannibals are ineffective. So we're just going to land on this island and walk across your bridge because you don't have a front door. And then they land, and then the guy, rotate! And then they rotate it. By the time they all get off the boat, it rotates, and they go, ah, get back on the boat, sail to the next island, and then it goes back to the other island. It protects them by trolling the pirates.
Oh, I forgot to lock the bridge.
To lock it. The ultimate fortress defense.
So if I walk outside right now, I wonder if the bridge is just like not connected or something, like just not extended.
So it loosely swings back and forth.
Just waving in the wind. Kai Island, I'm not connected. Deal with it. Alright.
That's what we had before. Okay.
Alarm clock.
That's it. You went too far. There we go.
I just think it must be rotating clockwise then.
Yep.
Which makes sense, I guess, because we were in a clock tower to come here, right? Alright. The code.
The code is Homer Simpson donut.
Yes.
Spike with squares in the middle. Or rectangle in the middle. Yes. Pitfall, like, spike trap with a ball above it.
I missed it.
And then half circle.
Be self-destruct sequence initiated. Time to GTFO.
Go back to Myst.
Sweet. Three ages down, one to go.
What does this guy say after we give him his paper?
Let's just wait for the game to finish giving him the paper. Yeah, let's do that after this maybe stops, hopefully.
It's getting quieter.
Yeah, it is, like, progressing. Once our hand cursor reappears, we're good. If it ever happens. Or we just lag out into oblivion.
Oh, there we go.
We're good. File. Save game. Game saved.
Yeah,
I think
it should be good.
Oh no, it's still mouse cursor. Oh, yeah. It's lagging up. We gotta wait about 30, 40, maybe 60 seconds for the game to save.
I wonder how big the save file is.
Such is the price of compatibility. Because before our saves were like that, right?
Yeah, but then we couldn't see anything.
But then we couldn't like see cutscenes or like operate gears.
Okay.
Those were hard times.
So what's Sirius got to say?
With each page I can see more clearly. Soon, free from this horrible prison. This book.
So who put what him in?
Visit the one remaining ape. You have not. Confident that. Brother Akinar is demented. He is guilty. He took advantage of the freedom our father had given us. Akinar began to do.
Want to grab the blue page? Or are we gonna like sit here watching this?
I asked you again.
Well, we gotta hear him out. What's he say?
Not retreat. He will destroy both myself and you, just as he destroyed the other creatures of Myst. Never will escape. You must simply bring the red. Oh, your wisdom, you will see that I am innocent and he is guilty.
As your face, like, twists into oblivion.
This forgotten island long ago. I will owe you my life, and you will be greatly rewarded.
She's gonna give us money. Or kill us.
Cash money. Or kill us.
You will be rewarded in heaven! Yeah! Let's go get the blue page.
Sounds good.
And then, hear what Crazy Pants has to say.
Click.
Where's that white page go?
Back to the mechanical age we go.
Do we ever try taking that white page to a Myst book?
There are no Myst books in Myst.
You're right.
I guess we could try taking it into like another age, right?
And then putting it in the Myst book? You always want to click the head. Spooky.
We'll go the long way.
I think you gotta do homework. Just hit the button.
Back to Myst. It's quite possible the reason we couldn't get the spaceship to work last time is lack of cutscenes or something.
Yep.
Alright, let's put that blue page in, and we'll save up, and then we'll watch this.
Yep.
Save game.
The frequent saving. The frequent lagging.
Yeah, well.
Better than it crashing and we have to do it all over again.
Exactly. I mean, we can like click through it really fast, like, because we know what we're doing now. So like, if we had to go like do that age, it wouldn't be too bad. But
it's still,
we're all saved up after the red page, so all we'd need to do is go retrieve the blue page, even if we crashed right now,
which wouldn't be too bad.
So we're okay.
There we go.
All right, let's check this out. What do you have to say, Akinar?
My friend.
He looks crazy.
Yeah, he does.
Bring in the blue pages. I see. Convinced. The Cirrus is guilty. Pray, do not release him. He will destroy me just as he does. Innocent bystander. I've been wrongly tricked into imprisonment.
Was he like red every time he gets angry?
You have observed his unbridled lust for riches!
See?
In the four remaining worlds. Some plot. It was almost perfect! Final blow to the father. He tricked him into believing that it was I who was the murderer. I didn't murder father. Bring me the remaining. Please. A liar. Full in a liar. Must not be free. Or they will be. Remaining blue pages from the last age of Myst. I must be free. You must free me. I cannot bear it here for eternity. Free me.
Okay, so just crazy mumbly.
Yeah, well, I mean, he apparently really wants to get out.
Yeah. He's also prone to just crazy mumbling fests.
No, I mean, like, just basically from watching those, I kind of get the idea that, like, Akinar might be the good guy. Like, I mean, like, the kind of things we've discovered so far kind of seems like Akinar was set up to look like a crazy man.
Yeah.
And Sirius is obviously, like...
Paul is clearly insane. Trust your wisdom.
Yeah, and just the way he talks to us in the book there, he's like... you know, whereas Akinar is like... Please help me, help me, help me, help me. You know,
I can't stay here for an eternity. It's driving me crazy.
Kind of like... a normal person would be if they were trapped in a book and really
keep in mind,
to
too, like... their father is dead.
Yeah.
One of them murdered their father. This
Sirius
much we know.
Says nothing about it. Akinar
nor does it look
Sirius.
Like he cares.
Yeah.
Whereas Aknar's like, father's dead, and he's like freaking out. So.
Sirius murdered him, he's
and then tried to blame me. Yeah, so it's like, hmm. Also, blue pages versus red pages.
Yeah, well.
But that could also be a clever trick. I guess we'll just have to find out in the last age before we make our decision.
Alright, so.
So go play Funky Town on the piano, and then.
Well, let's make sure we're all powered up.
Looks like it.
Gotta make sure those 59 volts are pumping.
Yep, 59 volts. Need that many generators to make that volt.
Well, maybe this will, like, do something now.
No, pull the lever. Yep. Yep. Okay. There we go.
Alright, well, I mean, I'm just looking at the time here, and I think before we jump into this fourth age, I think this is actually a good place to stop the stream for today.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll get into that next week.
Yeah, we actually solved this puzzle already, like, last time, but we didn't have the cutscene, so this book didn't show up here.
It just, like, played beep noises.
It would just do the thing, and then nothing happened.
Yeah, like, froze for a second, and
yeah,
we're
the,
like, okay.
The first time we did it, it froze. And then, like...
hit the switch again, boop, 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 boop. Okay. Hit it again, does nothing. Okay,
yeah,
guess.
So we, like, screwed around with the panel for a little bit. Yeah, we did all that last week, so... that's why it was just ready to go for us this week. But yeah, this is a good place, I think.
Save an end for
save,
the week.
Save the game.
We learned a lot.
Oh, yeah. I mean, just having the game working properly is, like, huge.
And seeing those cutscenes is... oh, there's a story to Myst,
yeah,
other than just wander around, yeah. And I guess we're finding these pages for this book. It's like, oh, no, we're trying to save brothers from these, like,
each
jail
other.
Book world things.
And we don't
like,
know
like, one of them's
one
killed
evil.
The dad, the other one's, like, caught, like, who knows what's going on.
Yeah, we're still not really sure. We get, like, conflicting stories, and, like, the only real story we do get is from them. I guess there's the message that he left for Catherine.
Which is just like, yo, they're crazy.
I suspect Akinar burned all of my books. Yeah.
Yeah.
And he was like, I'm going to find them, or something like that. And, like, I don't know.
Yeah, and then I guess he confronted them and was murdered.
I guess. I mean, why, though? Like, in all of the writings, like, about the books and the ages, everything seemed good, you know? They were, like...
I think maybe...
father and sons, just chilling out, visiting all these worlds, having a good time.
I think we're gonna have to go back and reread them and stuff.
Well, I mean,
well there's
really
also that
no,
white
like...
page. What's on that white page? And what book do we put it in?
Oh...
because that could be, like, his dying confession or something like that. It's like, I was stabbed by Sirius.
Well, we're not going to touch that next, but...
that's unsolved mystery.
We'll maybe, like, look at that next time.
It's probably just Catherine's note. I came to the island, got your message, read the thing on the holograph chart, went, nope.
Couldn't figure out how to delete it, because I don't know what operating system you're running, but there's no recycling bin, so...
so
I kind of just left it for strangers to find.
I just kind of noped off this island.
You gotta think, though, that piece of paper that telling us to, like, you know, count the marker switches and then go there, when was that left here? Because if that was left here, like, out in the elements for, like, it couldn't have been here that long. You gotta think about that.
It's true, yeah. Probably right after.
It couldn't have been sitting there for very long, because, like, it was pretty good condition. Like, actually, yeah, I mean, we can run over there and, like, take a look at that, for sure. So, like, I mean, look at this. Like, it's a little crumpled in a bit, but, like, doesn't look like there's very much weathering going on here. You know, it hasn't rained, clearly.
Yes.
Or this would be destroyed, so...
It looks like it was ripped out of something. Like, hastily scrawled. Very fantastically neat writing, hastily scrawled.
Yeah.
On a page ripped out of a book. It's been stepped on, probably, a couple times there.
Stepped on, yeah, by no one else?
I guess. I don't know.
Us?
Probably. It's all crinkly.
I guess. So yeah.
So questions about it. So many questions left unanswered.
Yeah, and I mean, hopefully we'll get like some of those answers once we pick up the fourth pages. Whether or not we can get them both, I guess we'll have to find out, because it might be like we get one and then...
And then the guy just like busts out of the book and stabs us in the chest and runs away.
Stabs us in the chest, burns the other book, and then like...
I mean, think about it, like... There's a sacrificial knife in... What's not serious, the other brother?
Channelwood? Akinar?
Yeah, Akinar. In his bedroom in Channelwood, there's a sacrificial knife there.
There are, like, sacrificial knives in all of his rooms.
Yeah, that's true. Along with axes and maces and other...
Weird tiki masks.
Yeah, weird voodoo death tiki masks.
The rose turning into a skull hologram.
Yeah, which is a little bit...
A little creepy.
A little bit weird.
Sirius's rooms are just filled up with, like...
gold jewelry and fine silks.
Drugs.
Yeah.
Drug paraphernalia.
Yeah, no, he did some drugs.
Yeah. So
I mean, there was poison in...
He was living the high life. Poison in Akinar.
Poison in Akinar's room, yeah.
Yeah.
But
a couple of his rooms, actually. Had the poison.
It got progressively worse. Like, the very first room in Channelwood had nothing in it. The second one had, like, one or two little vials, and then that one was, like, a whole death chamber full of poison.
Severed head.
Yeah. Wonder where we're going to find a rocket ship here.
Electrocution cage.
Yeah.
Like, I'm actually kind of surprised that we could flip that switch to, like, electrify stuff, and, like, we never use that.
No, it's just there. It's like, it's what just, is this? Oh, it's a death cage. Okay.
Usually when it's just a thing, you can just look at it. You can't actually interact with it, which is interesting, I guess, as a puzzle element, because this is kind of a game where, like, we're going around interacting with stuff, you know, like, that's what we want to do. So when you put something that's interactable in there, but isn't actually used to progress... in the plot and to
it's
solve
like a
the
red
puzzles.
Herring kind of
yeah totally a red herring, and I'm not entirely opposed to those in puzzle games, adventure games, but when you do put them in, like, you can't just have like a gratuitous amount of red herrings and like
the wind up bird.
Yeah, the wind up bird, like it has to be something, I guess, that
those,
like,
those little things that you mess over and they change color.
Yeah, it has to be something that, like, looks like maybe it's relevant, but at the same time looks like, you know, there's not really much you can do with it, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, like...
Like, the, I would say the wind-up bird was very much just a wind-up bird.
Yeah.
But there was the, like, the D8, the D12, and the D20 there.
Yeah, those seemed like they might be
mouse over them, the different ones light up, they have different colors, and it's like, okay, is this part of a puzzle? Like, do I have to know what colors, what shape, and match later? Like, it's stuff that you absorb into your memory, and you try to remember it, but when in reality, all you really need to do is look at the elevator and be like, oh, there's a switch above that, and go to the middle floor.
Exactly. I mean, that's a good kind of puzzle. See, like, the elevator has enough complexity to it that there is an actual puzzle to solve. Like, whereas you have something like the wind-up bird, and, like, that's all you can do, right? So you think, well, okay, there's not much here, right? There's not much space for me to explore. Whereas the elevator, you know, it's got, like, three different floors. There's the top floor is just this room, like, where we can't walk
can't
anywhere.
Do anything.
All we can do is turn around and get back into the elevator.
And stare at the ceiling.
And stare at the ceiling, right? So, like, they add just enough to kind of, like, tip you off. Because, like, when you stare at the ceiling, you can kind of see, like, two levers that look like the simulation levers on top of the elevator. So then you're like, well, okay, so
how do I
that
get up
looks
there?
Like, but how do I get up there, you know? And then, like... it might not be apparent at first, right? But obviously we managed to figure it out.
Well, I remember the channel wood with the tree, where it had to go up, and then you go in it, and it goes back down. And I was like,
right.
Well, there's a middle floor in that elevator. Why would there be a middle floor? Like, it did nothing. We looked at that previously.
Because there was nothing out there. It was just a wall. We could see the wall.
Yeah, exactly.
Inside the window.
So I was like, could we, like, run in the elevator, hit the buttons like a kid on an elevator, and run out and see what happens? And sure enough, we could.
Yeah. And then that brought it down to the middle floor, and it turned out, because that was another thing that wasn't quite clear, because, like, we look up there and we see those things. It's like, well, how do we get up there? Is there a ladder around here? I can't really walk around this thing, you know? So, you know, it's not quite clear that those switches are on top of the elevator.
They're just up above it.
But because the elevator gives you enough space to experiment with it, to explore it, you eventually find the switches. You know, you find out how to get the elevator to where you need to be so that you can activate the switches. So, I mean, I feel like the puzzles in the... I mean, last week we were kind of stuck for a bit. Like, we hopped around, like, we completed Channelwood, like, super quick, like, first week. But then last week, we were just, like, spent a lot of time stuck. Like, we unlocked the ship age. We couldn't unlock the gear age because of our compatibility issues. And we unlocked the spaceship age unknowingly, I guess, because, again, compatibility issues prevented us from actually getting into the age. But we did everything we needed to. So, like, we made some progress last week. But a lot of the time we found ourselves stuck, which turns out now is straight up because of the compatibility issues.
Yeah.
Like, once we got the compatibility things resolved this week, I feel like most of our play today, we didn't really get too stuck.
Or not only that, but, like, aside from Gear Island, we didn't do a whole lot of new things. It was just running around and being like, okay, let's do everything we've done before that didn't have a reaction, now that we can watch videos and get all that cutscenes and all that stuff. And sure enough, we learned a lot. Today was... It had puzzle solving in it, but it was more environmental and immersion in the world of Myst, of figuring out, like, hey, there's actually a story going on that we just didn't know beforehand.
Right. And of course that story helped us to continue, right? Where we were, because when we left off last week, we were kind of stuck because we didn't really know where to go. Like, we had gained access to the ship world. We couldn't access the other worlds because of compatibility issues.
Yeah.
So,
but at the time, we didn't even realize it, because we did some stuff in the ship world, and then last week we said, like, okay, well, we can't really get anything done here. Maybe we got to learn something in another world. So we went to go learn another world and go over there, but we couldn't get there from compatibility.
Right.
Which I also thought, too, was like, okay, well, I thought Myst was linear, or not linear, open world.
Yeah.
But then it seemed linear in the sense of, like, no, you have to go to the stone ship thing, because, like, these other ones don't work. It turned out just compatibility.
Yeah, it is still totally open world. You can go to any of the four ages you want to, in any order. You don't necessarily need to go one age, then another. I think because we did find those two pieces of paper there in the Channelwood and the Stoneship world, I feel like those are the first two that you're probably supposed to go to. But then again, it doesn't really matter too much. Like, that's just telling you about the marker switch thing, which we actually managed to figure out on our own, because it's really simple.
It's
even the paper even says it's really simple.
It's simple. Just turn them all off, then turn it on. Okay.
So, yeah, that's kind of funny. But we did manage to, like, make a lot of progress today, and, like, we're definitely not stuck. Like, when we come back next week, we know exactly what we're doing. We know exactly where we're going into a new age, which...
It's exciting.
We may then proceed to get stuck, but today, like, solving the mechanical age, we did that. I think I opened the hint menu once, and we didn't even, like, look, like, through all the hints. It was just, like, the first one, like, look around in circles. It's like, okay, well, I'm in the elevator, which is a circle, and I'm moving. So
yeah,
then
it's move in circles. Well, the elevator is a circle, and you're moving up in it, so... We're moving in a circle.
And then we got out, and then we look at the switches, and then, like, we kind of, like, got it from there, right? So,
the map feature is very nice, though.
Yeah.
Actually being able to figure out whose room is who.
Now, I don't know if that wasn't working last week and in previous weeks because of the thing, or if I just never noticed, because you have to click down here off of the screen for it to come up with a thing. And this is actually a very useful tool because, I mean, personally, I don't really like it. Because
I'd rather figure it out on my own.
Exactly. I like exploring the game for myself. I like progressing through it. I like discovering things. I like the challenge. You know, getting stuck to me doesn't feel bad. I mean, unless I'm stuck, like if I'm stuck on the same part for like an hour, then maybe I start to feel kind of bad because like there's just something I'm not getting, right?
Yeah, it's just headbutting a wall and hoping for best at that point, usually.
But if I, you know, I can be stuck for a little bit and like that's totally fine. And I mean, like I used some of the hints there, like especially on the stone ship world, we used the hints because like we weren't quite sure. We had explored a lot of it before, right?
Yeah.
And
we were trying to figure out where we haven't explored.
Right.
Because like we did it all. We hit the buttons. We even went to the
telescope. We found all the pages. You know, we went to the telescope. We found where the lighthouse was on the telescope. Like, we did everything that the hints prompted us to do. And except the one thing we didn't do, I guess, was press the right button on the compass. Because, like, we did press a couple of buttons that we thought were the right buttons. Because, like, the only significant thing we saw out of the telescope was the lighthouse. So we're like, okay, those coordinates must mean something. So we go to the compass and we see, okay, well, there are 36 buttons around the compass.
So
it's 360 degrees.
There you go, 10 degrees each.
And exactly, exactly.
But the lighthouse was at 135. So it was very much like, okay, well, which one do we hit? I guess, the lighthouse can't do it because there's only in degrees of tens, not in degrees of 35 and everything.
Mm-hmm. And because of the button placement, like, the arrow pointing dead north on that compass pointed directly to a button. So dead north, you think, is going to be zero, is going to be the 0 degree marker, right?
Yeah.
So when you got that as a 0 degree marker, you think, okay, well, the next button's 10 degrees, 20 degrees, 30 degrees, 40 degrees, right? But ultimately, it turned out to be they were increments of 5, I guess, because we had to hit, like, the 13th, 12th button or whatever, mm-hmm. and, like, that was the 135. So, but, I mean, ultimately, I still feel like we solved that puzzle by ourselves.
Yeah. Well, we knew that we had to hit a button on the compass corresponding to something on the telescope.
Exactly.
Like, we understood the mechanic of it, it's just it didn't work for whatever reason. Could be because of the compatibility. Maybe we actually didn't hit the right button, who knows?
So then we did actually use the hint there to hit the right button, but I honestly do kind of feel a little bit bad about that, but I mean, I can't really like guilt myself too much because we did all the work. You know, we kind of did solve it on our own. Like we figured out the corresponding relationships and we found out like what we needed to do. We just I guess didn't quite get there. Right?
It was one of those moments of when you use a hint in a puzzle game, it's like, okay, I'm stuck, I have no idea what to do, and use a hint, and it happens, and you're like, oh, so that's what I had to do, and then move on. It wasn't one of those situations.
Yeah.
It was a situation of like,
well, I knew that!
I've done everything here, and it's like, well, do this, and you're like, I've already done that, and then it works, and then the light comes on, and you're like, yeah, that's, okay, whatever. Like, yeah. I knew that was exactly what was going to happen. I knew I had to hit something on this compass, because that's the only other option we had, was to hit the buttons on the compass. We even said we might have brute forced it.
Yep.
And hit each one individually, and we knew that the underwater lamp was going to turn on.
Yeah.
So it's using the hint didn't really spoil it, because we already knew what needed to happen and how to go about doing it. It was just very much, why didn't it work for us when we originally did it?
Yeah, now I'm just going to go ahead here and say, like, we're not using hints for the rest of this game.
Yeah, no.
And no, not happening, because we're going to play this the way it's supposed to be played. The map, however, we're allowed to use the map.
Yeah. Because the map's actually, like...
The map's nice.
And it doesn't even tell you, nice like, you have. Are here like, in this. It just tells you, like, these are the things. Perhaps the map will help you, yeah, because it just tells
giant
you...
Giant tree elevator.
Okay.
Stone ship book room. Sunken gear.
Clock tower control box. Clock tower.
Breaker switch.
So.
Towers.
So there's some things it says that are kind of like...
Hidden gear bridge. So, okay, maybe there's a little bit of stuff on the map that, like, gives things away. But nothing really that's not too obvious, you know?
Yeah. It doesn't tell you how to solve the puzzles. It's just, like, pedestal with symbols. It's like, okay, well, I knew I had to get the symbols.
So, for the rest of the run, we're allowed to use the map. We're not going to use hints.
Hmm.
So we're going to pick this up next week.
And
now that we've got the compatibility things sorted out, I'm liking this game a lot more. Like,
oh, yeah.
The cinematics are great. I mean, especially like you consider the time.
They're live action, full like, voiced, everything
yeah,
put into it.
Really well done, too. I mean, the way that every time you get a new page, it gives you a new cinematic, whereas like a little bit, you get like a little bit more from that character, right?
Yeah.
And they're both like feeding you this story, and like really they're the only ways that the story's delivered to you. And so like you're just kind of like feeding off of these two characters who are delivering this story to you in these cutscenes, and like,
and you gotta figure out what the truth
really,
is yourself.
Really, really good. Additionally, like when we go to different worlds, the little like fly around thing
is nice.
It's nice. It's a very cool effect, and like it gives us like a view of the world, right? So like we kind of have an idea of what we're going into.
It was like before we went to Chinawood, we're just like, okay, where are we? And we know there's a windmill from this book because we're just going off the drawings in the books.
And we actually went and copied the map out of that book because, like, maybe if we had a fly around, we would have like understood the world a little bit better.
Yeah,
you know, we would have.
Or even with the map button.
Yeah, or with the map. Yeah, for sure. So, we learned some new things today that we can do. We're not going to use the hints though. No.
So
you know, three out of four ages down.
Just. Spaceship Age. Do we have a name for that age? It was the one with all the volcanoes that exploded and everything, right?
Yeah,
the
tectonic rift. I think there was a name for that age. Because like there's the Mechanical Age, Stone Ship Age, Chinawood. This is this book, I believe. Yeah, this world is very beautiful. Does he give a name to the world?
No idea.
Age seems to change rapidly. Transition for the generation. All right, this is the one with all that kind of stuff blanked out, right? So this is gonna be interesting. I don't think he names this age.
No, he doesn't.
Not in this book, at least. I know there was another age mentioned in one of
Everdunes
the other books.
Everdunes. Yeah.
Yeah, so I don't know if that's Everdunes or not. But anyway. No, Everdunes talks about, like, Pran. Whereas this other world, there's no people there. At least that he writes about.
Osmian
Age.
Osmoan Age, yeah.
Or
although keep in mind though, there's other ages that were destroyed by, I guess it was Akinard?
I'm pretty sure it's the Osmoan Age right here.
Okay.
That's what that one is, because like here Sirius has suggested that I allow him and his brother to stay. We're talking about in Chinawood, right? And like any other book there, he's like,
I gotta go back to Chinawood. Yeah.
Yeah.
So it must be the Osmoan Age. Okay. So I'm excited for next week. Have to go to the last age and figure out who's guilty of murder.
Yeah, so
hopefully we don't find any severed heads in a treasure chest.
Yeah, that's creepy. We're gonna save the game. Right?
Yeah.
Alright.
Save it again.
Alright, right, we'll just do one more save. And then I guess that's gonna be it for today.
Yep.
So this has been Lost in the Myst, episode 3. We continued to play Myst. Made some progress today. Pretty solid progress. So I've been Soulfire.
And I've been Shmoka.
And we will see you next week.
Yep.